Okay. Good morning to all. Health is wealth. You must have all heard this saying, and it's something very much relevant in the time of this pandemic because it's very much essential for all of us to stay healthy to fight the pandemic. So, with that view, KBS has organized a lecture series under Swatantrata ka Amrit Mahotsav, and the lecture series is titled Healthy Lifestyle. So today we are immensely honored to have Dr. Rupesh Kumar CB, Senior Medical Officer, Ayurveda at ESIC Model and Super Speciality Hospital, Ashramam, Kollam. So we'll be giving you a lecture on healthy living styles. On behalf of the entire Kendriya Vidyalaya family, I accord a very warm welcome to Dr. Rupesh Kumar. Hearty welcome, Doctor. Hearty welcome to the program. And Doctor, I think your mic is muted.
Okay. Well, thank you, ma'am.
I was just checking, Doctor, whether there is any problem or not. Okay. Chilan, I'm sure you're going to be very much benefited from this program. And this is supposed to be an interactive lecture series. So you are supposed to, after the lecture, during the lecture, doctor may be asking you questions. You have to respond. And after the lecture, you are given time to interact with doctor and also clarify all your doubts. So once again, doctor, hearty welcome to the program. I request you to start the program. And children, all of you, keep your videos open and listen very carefully. Doctor, please.
Thank you, madam, for introduction. Good morning, all teachers and students. Today is World Heart Day. You all know it's giving importance to heart health of our heart this day, September 29th. On this day, we are discussing about Ayurveda lifestyle, lifestyle modification through our Ayurveda, means arranging our daily life according to Ayurvedic principles. That is, we are going to discuss today. Now I am starting the slides. Can you all see my slides?
Yes, doctor. It's visible. We can see it.
Okay. I'm starting, madam. The word Ayurveda means knowledge of life. The word Ayu means life and Veda means knowledge. So, Ayurveda is the knowledge of life, the science of life. It is a holistic system giving prime importance to disease prevention than its treatment. Ayurveda's prime importance is to prevent a disease rather than treating a disease. So in Ayurveda, there is a special branch dealing with this health, that is Swasthavritta. In Ayurveda, in Sanskrit, and a healthy person is described as Swastha. And Swasthavritta is the branch of medicine in Ayurveda dealing with social and preventive medicine. We all know the definition of health given by World Health Organization. In Ayurveda, the definition of health is having good appetite, good and easy digestion, proper and regular elimination of waste out of body, फीलिंग ऑफ लाइटनेस इन बॉडी माइंड एंड सेंसेस, गुड एंड टाइमली स्लीप विथ फ्रेश वेकिंग अप, फीलिंग ऑफ वेल बीइंग, गुड स्ट्रेंथ इन बॉडी एंड गुड मेटाबॉलिज्म. एनी डिविएशन टू अबव सिम्टम्स अबव साइंस नीड टू बी एड्रेस्ड. देन वी कैन असेस अवर सेल्फ वेदर वी आर हेल्थी और नॉट. दिनचर्या मीन्स डेली रेजिमेन, डेली रूटीन. बाई प्रॉपरली अरेंजिंग द डेली रूटीन वी कैन हैव ए गुड लाइफ स्टाइल अकॉर्डिंग टू आयुर्वेदा. दिनचर्या इंक्लूड्स ए सेट ऑफ गाइडलाइंस फॉर हेल्थी बॉडी एंड माइंड. फॉलोइंग दीज गाइडलाइंस विल मेंटेन एन ऑप्टिमम इम्यूनिटी एंड देयर बाई हेल्थ. Dinacharya starts with waking up early in the morning. Ayurveda says to wake up in Brahma Muhurta. Brahma Muhurta means the Muhurta of Brahma, the creator. Muhurta is 48 minutes according to Ayurveda. This Brahma Muhurta starts about 1.5 hours before sunrise. If precisely saying, 1 hour and 36 minutes before sunrise is the beginning of Brahma Muhurta, and it lasts for 48 minutes. For example, if sunrise is at 6 a.m., Brahma Muhurta starts at 4:26, and it ends at 5:12 a.m. This is Brahma Muhurta. It is ideal for study purpose also for you students. This is the ideal time for waking up according to Ayurveda. After waking up, the first thing is to evacuate the bowel and bladder. This is very important. One should immediately attend to natural urges whenever they come without being busy in other activities. According to Ayurveda, these are adharaniya vegas. Vegas means urges. Adharaniya means we should not kept it in the body. Example, bowel, bladder, the vomiting, the sneezing, etc. These 13 vegas, 13 urges are there. Our body urges. These should be attended as early as possible. Do not forcefully suppress or induce natural urges of our body. It may lead to various diseases. Meanwhile, we should suppress the natural urges of our mind. What are the natural urges of our mind? Our anger, our greed, our jealousy. These should be suppressed. Suppressed means transformed. Transformed to other good qualities like love, compassion, etc. Then first thing, brushing and tongue cleaning. For this, Ayurveda suggests kadu tikka kashaya rasa. We can use herbal tooth powders with this kadu tikka kashaya rasa. Kadu means pungent, tikka means bitter, kashaya means astringent. This cleaning prevents growth of microorganism. It enhances local immunity. Next one procedure. This is instilling 2 drops of medicated oil in both nostrils, morning and evening. Anutaila is a commonly used medicine for this purpose. This produces a biofilm, preventing entry of microorganisms. This is to be avoided in acute infections like common cold, nasal block, fever, etc. Next, another procedure to be done, gargling with gingerly oil for 1-2 minutes, then rinse with warm water. This prevents entry of microorganisms. These two procedures are advised by Ayush Ministry in this COVID pandemic situation for enhancing our immunity. Pradimarsha Nasya and Kavala or Gandosha. देन कम्स ऑयल मसाज और अभ्यंगा। अभ्यंगा इज ऑल्सो ए पार्ट ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट इन आयुर्वेदा, बट इट शुड बी ए पार्ट ऑफ इन आवर डेली रूटीन ऑल्सो। मसाज होल बॉडी विथ जिंजरली ऑयल और मेडिकेटेड ऑयल, स्पेशली ओवर हेड, ईयर्स एंड फुट। इम्प्रूव ब्लड सर्कुलेशन, एक्सक्रीशन ऑफ मेटाबॉलिक वेस्ट एंड इम्प्रूव इम्यूनिटी। दिस अभ्यंग शुड बी अवॉइडेड इन इन्फेक्शन इन डिसीज कंडीशन। दिस ऑल स्टेप्स आर दिस दिनचर्या ऑल स्टेप्स आर मेन्शन फॉर ए हेल्थी पर्सन। दिस अभ्यंग डिलेज एजिंग, इट्स रिलीव्स एक्सेशन एंड एक्सेस ऑफ वादा, मीन्स एक्स एंड पेन्स ऑफ बॉडी। इट इम्प्रूव विशन, नरिशस बॉडी टिश्यूज, प्रलॉन्ग्स एज, इंड्यूस गुड स्लीप एंड इम्प्रूव स्किन स्किन टोन एंड कॉम्प्लेक्शन। दिस हेड, ईयर्स एंड फुट आर स्पेशली मेंशन टू बी मसाज्ड विथ ऑयल, बिकॉज मसाजिंग दीज पार्ट्स गिव्स ए स्पेशल डिक्रीज इन अवर स्ट्रेस हॉर्मोन्स एंड इंक्रीज ऑफ दिस सेरोटोनिन विच इंड्यूस स्लीप एंड मेलाटोनिन विच इज ए प्लेजर हॉर्मोन। सो अभ्यंगा इज ए स्ट्रेस रिलीवर एंड इंड्यूस स्लीप ऑल्सो। एक्सरसाइज, व्यायाम, व्यायाम इज an unavoidable part of our daily life, we all know, but Ayurveda suggests to do exercise according to one's own strength, means over exercise should be avoided. It should be done according to season also. That is, in summer season we are having slightly less body strength, so exercise should be also accordingly. Benefits of exercise are lightness of the body. Ayurveda says lightness of the body, it improves ability to do work, it increases digestion power, burns excess fat, it brings body into good shape. We all know exercise controls weight, combat health conditions like diabetes and hypertension. It improves mood, it boosts energy, and it is also better for sleep. And abhyanga and exercise both are good for getting very good sleep. Then comes bathing, snana. It is also an important part of our daily routine. After abhyanga and exercise, it comes bathing. It improves our digestion. It acts as an aphrodisiac and prolongs life. It increases enthusiasm and strength. It stimulates metabolism and eliminates metabolic waste materials, which in turn refreshes the body. It is associated with strengthened immune function. So, bathing is important. Warm water should be used for bathing, except for head. For head bath, we should use normal water. Another important part of our daily routine, that is intake of food. According to Ayurveda, ahara is mahavaishajya, means the best medicine. Ahara is the best medicine for us. So while taking food, we should fill half portion of our stomach with food, only half portion. Then 1/4 with water or liquid portion. Then 1/4 should be kept empty. We should always take food which is easy to digest. We should take food only after the previously taken food is digested. Means clean belching. When we are getting a clean belchi only, we are supposed to take the next food. राइस ग्रूवल एंड ग्रीन ग्राम इज आइडियल चॉइस इन द डिसीज कंडीशन ऑल्सो वी टेक दिस कंजी इन मलयालम राइस ग्रूवल एंड ग्रीन ग्राम कंजी पयर दिस किंडल्स अग्नि एंड हेंस इम्यूनिटी While taking food, we should take care of some more points. Means we should sit for food with all the accessories nearby. In between our food, we cannot go anywhere to take spoon, pepper, salt, etc. We should be very calm and quiet. And very attentive towards our food. After taking care of grandparents, our small children, etc., we should go for a food. Our food should contain some oily part should be there. It should not be so dry. It should contain all the six rasas. In Ayurveda, there are six rasas. Like in Ayurveda, it says madhura, levana, amla, kadu, tikta, kashaya. These six rasas should be in our diet. Our sadhya is an example, which is having all these six tastes. Water we drinking along with or after food is known as anupana. Anupana should be opposite properties, should be of opposite properties of food we ingested. This will help in proper digestion of the food. For example, if we are taking a heavy food like biryani, we should take only, at least only take warm water with along with it for the proper digestion of this biryani. Do not take a shake, etc., which harms our digestion. Meditation or prayer or pranayama. Best time for this is Brahma Muhurta, as we said earlier. This reduces stress hormones and thereby enhances immunity. Sleep or Nidra, according to Ayurveda, Nidra is the second mother to all living beings. That much importance is given to this Nidra, sleep. According to Ayurveda, there are three supporting pillars which support our life. That these three things are ahara, nidra, and brahmacharya. Brahmacharya for you students, this brahmacharya is studying only. These three things are very important. The quality and duration of the sleep is very important. At least 8 hours of sleep is needed for teenagers. A good sleep sharpens our brain. Healthier hair, mood boost, athletic achievement, weight control, steadier blood sugar. It also enhances our immunity. This is night regimen. Next one. This pray for God before going to bed. Pray to God. Massage the sole of your feet, as said earlier in Abhyanga. Massage the sole of your feet with oil before going to bed to induce a sound sleep. Sleep in a comfortable, wide, smooth bed that should be high up to the knee level is ideal. Go to bed within 3 hours after sunset, that is before 10 p.m. We should take our dinner at least 2 hours before going to bed. That is ideal. After these things, Ayurveda suggests some code of conducts that should be followed for a healthier personal and social relationship with everyone. That is, the essence of this code of conduct is compassion towards all living beings, donation as per ability, controlling the activities of the body, speech and mind, feeling selfishness in the interest of others, that is, looking after the interest of others as his own. These are sufficient rules of good conduct. For an intelligent person, the word is a teacher. Hence, one should imitate the word after carefully considering their meaning and effects of such actions. For a wise person, this world itself is a teacher, good teacher. What is happening in this world? Why this happened? This we should analyze and act accordingly. Then, the end of every day, we should constantly think. And during the day also, we should constantly think of how is my day going and how is my nights are going, and adopt the right way will never become a victim of sorrow. Always analyze yourself. What is I am doing? Is it right? Summarizing, a person who practices regularity in lifestyle and mindfulness in eating habits is deliberate in all his actions, not overindulged in worldly pressures, who is generous, truthful, forgiving nature, who is service-minded and helpful to one's own kin, will remain unaffected by disease. This is the ways to healthy life according to Ayurveda. Thank you all. The presentation is over.
Okay. Now, children, it's time for you to interact with doctor. If you have any doubts or any clarification required, this is the time for you. You can start. Hello, children. Adhija. Okay. Anyone? Any doubts, children? You can interact with doctor. Yes. Fatima. Doctor, any other tip for them so that they can focus more on their studies, something connected with their studies? Especially on this day, World Heart Day, something that children need to do so that, for the health of their heart, or something else which they will be useful for them so that they can better concentrate on their studies. Any tips of that sort? Okay,
in Ayurveda, ghee is mentioned for our intelligence, memory, all brain functions is improved with the intake of ghee. So I advise all children to take ghee at bedtime. 1 teaspoon of ghee at bedtime will improve all their brain functions and improves their memory and improves their studies, etc. This is very good for all. And we can take Triphala also. Triphala is a very good drug mentioned by Acharyas to take daily. Alternatively, this Triphala also can be taken with honey and ghee. Daily intake of Triphala is also advised. It is also good for our heart.
Any specific exercise, doctor, which will help them concentrate better? Something easy to do, which they can do every day, so that they will be benefited.
They can practice pranayama. Pranayama is best for their memory, increasing their memory, intelligence, etc. Under the guidance of your yoga instructor, all of the students can practice pranayama. It is very simple.
That's actually being done, doctor, every day during the morning assembly. Now, children, anything to clarify, doctor? Otherwise, we can wind up this program. Anyone? It has come to a chat box, doctor. One doubt has come to the chat box. Children, you can even send to the chat box also. If you are... Atija, so how to take care of my eyes after exposure to increased screen time?
Yes. Again, Triphala is the drug of choice for our health of our eyes. We can wash our eyes with Triphala decoction, means aqueous solution of Triphala, boiling Triphala powder, and cooling, and after avoiding the sedimentation of the powder, we can use this Triphala water for washing our hands and washing our eyes. And this some eye exercises are there for strain relief of our eyes. This we can adopt these things for health of our eyes.
Children, others also, you can send your doubt through the chat box. Doctor will be there with us for 5 more minutes. And so please utilize this time to clarify your doubts. Okay, another doubt has come, doctor, through the chat box. Okay, and there are many coming to the chat box now. Another one, doctor. What will happen after our eyes are paining by the sunlight? And
so, you are not supposed to directly look at the sun. This should be avoided. Give sufficient rest to our eyes. Any organ should not be utilized more. It should be given proper rest, any organ.
Doctor, one more doubt is there that has come through the chat box. Another one. Why is my leg paining even after a small exercise or after dancing? Legs are paining, and what would be there?
Paining legs is sometimes it is a part of our growth also, but you can take any medicated oil in Ayurveda like Dhanandaram and apply it and massage it and give some wash it with some warm water daily 2 times. This will relieve these symptoms.
Okay, children, anyone else? Anybody else? Okay. Doctor, I think, okay, another doubt has come, doctor. Fatima, so for maintaining a proper fitness, practicing exercise under us, whether practicing under a trainer is required or whether they can do it themselves or not, for staying fit, whether a trainer's help is required.
No, a trainer is not required. Regularly walking, regular walking is enough for staying fit. A brisk walking for 30 minutes every day is enough for staying fit. Walking is the best exercise.
Another doctor, can we drink cool drink after biryani? I think doctor has already mentioned about that in the lecture itself,
Oh,
that they
yes,
can take.
it is not a dish. It affects our digestion. Warm water is always advisable, like in heavy food like biryani.
And children mostly prefer that, so it's not, it's harmful.
Yes.
So can we
Yes.
please advise an exercise for headache? An exercise for headache, they're asking, doctor.
Exercise headache, we should analyze the reason behind the headache, whether it is related with eye problems or something else. Then accordingly we can solve the problem.
Doctor, another doubt is how many hours they need to exercise in summer? Should we exercise in summer? How many hours?
In Ayurveda, it says Artha Shaktiya Nishevya, means we should exercise taking half of the strength. Half of our strength should be used for exercise. In summer, if you are feeling tired while doing exercise, you should stop it. Half of our strength should be used at any time for exercise. Over exercise is danger.
Another doubt is, doctor, regarding eye pain. I think that we have already discussed. And next one is body is paining even after a very simple, even without exerting. One child has asked, the body is pain. My body will pain while playing any sports.
Okay. That leg pain, etc., is also a part of growth. It should not bother about this.
Okay, doctor. I think so. Any more doubts, children? Any other doubt? Okay, doctor. I think it's time to wind up the program. And on behalf of the entire Kendriya Vidyalaya family, I express my sincere gratitude to you, sir. First of all, for readily accepting our invitation to give this lecture. I know without any difficulty, you readily accepted our invitation. Second, for giving this very useful, there are so many questions again coming, and for giving this lecture, and I'm sure children have very much benefited, and also to give them time to clarify their doubts, for clearing their doubts very patiently. Thank you,
Okay.
doctor. Thank you very much on behalf of everyone. Once again, I thank you for being with us and for delivering this very valuable lecture. We'll be very
Thank
much
you, madam.
happy to have you for more lectures in future too. Thank you so much,
Thank
doctor.
you, ma'am. Thank you, madam. This is my first experience, and I'm thankful for you. Thankful to you for giving me this nice opportunity.
I've invited at
Thank you.
the advice instruction of principal sir. Our principal is Dr. G. Sashikumar sir. And he's traveling, that's why sir is not able to join or interact with you. So I told to
Okay.
convey his gratitude to you for being for giving this lecture for the
Okay.
Vidyalaya. And it's a lecture
Thank you,
series,
madam.
doctor. We'll be arranging more such lectures on healthy lifestyle. And we expect that you'll be a part of this program in future too. Thank you, doctor.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you, madam.